Hello and welcome to another wonderful edition of our machine learning class. Today we're going to be using linear regression to perform prediction. So we're going to train a model with some data from the housing in Monroe, New Jersey, United States. And we should be able to predict, given a new area, we should be able to predict the price of such house. That's what we're going to be looking at. And in this class, we're going to be looking at how can we import a CSV file, a file that we made in Excel, saved it as a CSV file, and that file is locally on our system, but we want to put it into the Jupyter Notebook environment and be able to use it to do a work. And that is what we're going to be trying out today. It's going to be very, very interesting. And for us to keep going, let me quickly share my screen. So I'm going to share my screen immediately so that we can continue. Is there anybody on earpiece? Can you get me? Am I clear on the earpiece? Who is on earpiece? It's clever. Okay, so let's continue immediately. The test that we are using for all our lectures are already on our website, www.tclassified.com. So I'm going to open it up so that you can see where we are taking our lectures from. The website has the codes and everything that will make your learning very, very easy. So once you get to tclassified.com, click on blog. Once you get to the blog, you're going to see machine learning. And that is the lecture that we are currently doing. In the morning, we'll learn about Django, using Django to develop online school. So you see, I just clicked on blog. If you scroll down, you're gonna, this is what we did in the morning. And now we're gonna be looking at machine learning. We've already done some classes in machine learning. And today we're gonna be continuing from where we left off. So we did introduction and we already did a simple regression. Today we're going to be doing prediction. Tomorrow we're going to be looking at clustering, and tomorrow we'll look at classification, next tomorrow clustering, then deep learning. So this is what we are looking at. You can see here it is written, machine learning with Python, linear regression in one variable. The sample problem we are doing is that we are predicting the home prices of Monroe, New Jersey, USA. So below is the table. This table, you're supposed to prepare this table in your Excel, MX Excel. So this is the exact table. So I'm going to go to my Excel, and this is where I prepared this table. You can see it's the same table. I open up Excel. Once you open up Excel, click here, type area, fill in the areas. Click here, type price, fill in the prices. It's as simple as that. When you're done, click on File. Click on Save As, Save As. You're saving as CSV. You're not saving as just normal Excel file. So you're saving as CSV. So make sure when you put the name is Home Prices. So just simply type in Home Prices. Once you're done, click here, Save Type, and make sure you select CSV, comma delimited. That is how you can simply make out your data and be able to use it to do machine learning. Very, very importantly, most of the data that you're going to be fetching by yourself, you're going to be putting it in Excel like this, make it out in CSV file, and then you can use it to do your machine learning. So that's how you collect your data. You can simply collect your data in MS Excel and use it. There are various ways you can use in getting your data. One will be using big data to do our work. We're going to learn how to get the data from some websites that already have this raw data, like Kaggle, UCL, and most of them. We'll be getting our data from there. But take an instance where you have to fetch your data by yourself. Like if I want to study my customers, I'm going to be here picking out their data with table. I'll write serial number here. Then here I'll write name, I'll write age, address, and everything. Then any customer that comes, I'll take down the data. using my biro in a paper I've drawn, you understand? Then after that, I'll open Excel and fill in those data just the way I just filled it in here. And now I will save it as CSV. Then I'll use it in Jupyter Notebook to run my machine learning. So that is how you prepare this, very, very important. Immediately after doing that, the next thing will be to open up your Jupyter Notebook, which you're gonna click on the search bar in your computer and just type in Jupyter. As you're typing it in, it's gonna come out. Once it comes out, just click on it. You can see my own here, Jupyter Notebook, Anaconda 3. So click on it. Once you click on it, it's gonna open up the command prompt for Anaconda command prompt. You can see this is it, Jupyter Notebook Anaconda 3, the Anaconda command prompt. This shows you that it is opening. So after a while, it's gonna now fully open up to this. So this is what you will see once it is done opening. Okay. So once you've opened your Jupyter Notebook to this point, the next thing will be to pick up the kernel that you're using. And we're using Python 3. That is the editor, and that is the notebook that we're gonna be using. So click on this Python 3, then a new Jupyter Notebook will be opened for you so that we can start working immediately. So you can see the processes we are going through. That is the typical process that you go through. If you prepared your data from MX Excel, which is one of the ways that you can pick out your data. We say that as a data scientist that you should be able to do what? Fetch your data, isn't it? Fetch your data, work on the data to make it look fine and can be used in Python environment, then use the Python to build out the model and then do your prediction. And those are the things we are gonna be doing, and we're gonna be taking them one after the other. Okay, so you can see that my Jupyter Notebook is open. What's the next thing I'm supposed to do? From your previous class, you're supposed to go to click on the what? Untitled one, so that you give it the title of this notebook that we're working on. So what should we call this notebook from what we did yesterday? What should we call it? Good, we can call it home. So I'm gonna call it home price prediction Ostino. I'm putting it because I've already done this before with home price prediction. So I'm gonna save this time around with home price prediction Ostino. Then I'm gonna click on rename. And once I do that, you can see now the name of this notebook is home price prediction Ostino. So we're gonna quickly start. What's the first thing we'll do from what we did the last time? First thing will be to import the models needed, isn't it? That's the first thing we do. So if you go to our website, like I said before, all the processes are already done there. So the models we import are pandas. Pandas is a data science model that you can use to draw out your table inside of your Jupyter Notebook. You can use it to do a whole lot of things. Then we are going to import NumPy. You already know what NumPy does. We are gonna import sqlen. You already know what sqlen does because we used it in the last time. So NumPy is for manipulation of numerical numbers into arrays and other things. Sqlen is for you to make predictions. And matplotlib is for you to plot graphs. Pandas is for you to organize it in good table. So we're gonna use all these. In the last class we did not use pandas. We just used only NumPy, sqlen, and matplotlib. But you can see this is an improvement to the last class. So I'm gonna pick up this importation that we're supposed to do. And I'm quickly gonna import them. I get to my Jupyter Notebook. I put them there to do the imports. Then I click on run. You must click on run. If you don't click on run, it will not affect. So you can see I'm importing pandas at what? PD. And I taught you guys about aliases. That aliases are very good, so that if you want to use pandas, it's going to use to write the whole of pandas, you just use PD, because you're importing pandas as PD. So pandas is already there, but you're using it as PD. You're importing NumPy as MP, you're importing sqlen as what? Linear underscore model, and you're actually importing linear model from SQLN, not as linear underscore model. So there's a model in SQLN known as linear model that is very good for you to use, and that's why you're importing it. Then you're importing matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. So with that, we can get together to what we want. So the first thing we are going to do is to read out the CSV file that is in our system. We need to read it out. And after reading it, we want to show it by using df. So we'll read it out and assign it to the variable df. Then we'll show it by just saying df. So that's the first thing we do. So I'm going to pick this up. I'm going to come here and put it. So once I put it, I'm going to click on run. Okay. So is everybody looking? Look, so that you see the error I'm correcting now, so that you don't make a mistake. So you see, once you pick this code from our website, you always have to do what? Correct it by making sure the single quote, you clean the single quote you have, replace it with the normal single quote. Then here you do the same thing. So make sure you do that. If you don't do that, it might not run well. So for you to get it very clear, you look at this place, you see that I have quotes here. So make sure you put the quotes where they are supposed to be. Okay. I'm gonna have gonna take this out. So if you're using double quote, make sure that you're consistent with your double quote. If you're using single quote, make sure you're consistent with single quote. So I'm using double quote now. So you can see it's read out this. Where did it read it out from? It's reading out CSV. You see that we're doing this with pandas. Without the PD, you cannot read out this CSV. So you're using pandas, and the function in pandas that you're using to read out is read underscore CSV. So, and it's in the read mode. Where are you getting the file from? Your C/user/document folder, data science, home prices. That's why I saved this file. So if I open this folder, you will see this directly. For you to know where your own directory is, just go to where you saved it. Click here on top, copy what you have here, that is it. You can see my C, users, user, document folder, data science. That's where I saved my own. So make sure you get to where you saved your own. So just copy this. Once you copy this, get to your file, paste it in here, then do /homeprices.csv. That is how you get to the directory. And once you get to the directory, you're supposed to see this table showing you the area and price. And you can see that this table is exactly the same as the table that we have here. Only that this one is colored because this one is in Excel. And I know that you know you can color this your own. If you select this and color it yellow, it can color. So you can now put borders if you want to put border. That is Excel. I'm not teaching you guys Excel. So this is similar to this now. So, but when you reference it from your Jupyter, this is what you see. So having done that, we are going to move forward. So the first line of code is simply reading out this CSV file from our internal locally saved Excel CSV code file. It's reading it with the pandas and with the function read underscore CSV and assigning it to this variable so that when you just put this variable, it will bring it out exactly. So that is the use of these pandas. So let's take the next line of action that we're going to perform now. So after reading out the file, what do we do next? The next thing will be to plot out using matplotlib. So let's plot this graph and see the way it looks. As you can see, we are having what? X against Y. So we can plot it out. So plot out using this code. I'm going to pick it up. We've used this before. We've done exactly this before. So I'm going to put it here. So once you put it, make sure you change all these. Make sure you're having the right quotes. So what are we doing? We are plotting the what? X label as area. That's what we are doing. We are using the X. Our X axis now is area. And our y-axis is what? Price. Can you see that? It's very simple. Then now, once you've labeled x and y-axis, the next thing will be to do what? PLT.scatter. Why are we using PLT? Because we imported matplotlib as what? PLT. So in PLT, there is this function known as scatter that enables you to plot the graph, plot a scatter diagram or graph. That's what we call it. So I'm going to make sure that I'm having red here. Why are we having red as the color? Who can tell me? Why do we put red as the color? Want the color of the line to be red. So I'm going to click on run. Okay, you can see I'm having error. So where could the error be from? Okay, so I'm going to check it out. I have df area against df.price. Then color is equal to red. Okay, I'm having double quotes here. So I'm going to take out one. That's where my error is from. I'm going to run again. Okay, so you can see my plots. So these dots are red in color because I'm using marker plus. And you can see the marker is plus. If you change this marker now to hash, let's change it to hash instead of plus. If you change it to hash and we run again, instead of having plus, you see I'm having hash now. I'm having a star and it's red. If I change this red to green and I run, I'm now having green. So that is how you plot out your scatter. So what's the next thing to do? The next thing will be to have our predicted prices because we want to perform prediction. So to do that, we're going to create a new variable known as new underscore df. That's what we're going to do. New underscore df. And it's going to simply take out our price and put it in a column. Then we'll put out what we've gotten. So to do this, like I said before, always make sure that you're having the right single quote. If you just pick it exactly the way it's on our site, it will not give you what you want. So get this like this, then run again. So you can see we are just putting up, we are just giving out what the areas are. Okay. So can anybody understand what this code is saying? It's saying df drop. We are trying to drop out the price column. So we dropped the price column and we're having only the area column. In database, whenever you use the word drop, drop simply means to take out. Okay. So let's move down. So this is actually how you can manipulate data in your, you're just using pandas. You're manipulating your data. Manipulating, looking at it. So let's continue. So what's the next thing we do? Can look at what the price looks like. So I'm gonna pick this out for us to look at our price. So we are assigning the, we are taking out price and assigning it to the variable price and we are showing it. So you run, so you can see all our prices. Very well done. So what is the next thing we do? The next thing will be to create our linear regression object. Just the way we created it for the simple graph we plotted yesterday. So let's create the linear regression object. So get back to home. Put this. So we are simply creating a variable reg and assigning the object linear regression. Where did we get our linear regression? We got it from the linear underscore model that we got from the sqlen. That's where we got it. Very, very simple. And immediately after getting that, we're able to use this variable and do dot fit in order to get our model. That's how you get your model. So I click on run. It runs that. So once you see linear regression, it means that it has run. So what is the next thing we do? The next thing will now be having created this regression and known where the line is, let's predict the price of 3,300 square feet. You see the price, the prices that we have. We have price for 2,600, we have for 3,000, we have for 3,200, we have for 3,600, we have for 4,000. So let's say you are told to predict the price for 3,300. It's gonna check out the data you already have and use its ability that is getting from the sklearn using the linear underscore model or linear regression to do the prediction, and that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna pick this out. So once you've trained your model, you can simply run your prediction. So simply say reg, because reg is a variable that you created using this linear regression, dot predict. So once you say dot predict, there's a function in the object reg in sklearn that is predict, and with that you can do the prediction. So once I click on run, you can see for the area of 3,300, the price is what? 628,715.75. That's the price that predicted the price for us. It's as simple as that. So what is the next thing I do? If I want to really build out my equation, y equals to mx plus c, I will need to know the coefficient and the intercept, isn't it? That's what we did yesterday. So let me find out. I want to build out this very equation the way it is. Y is the price. M is the what? M is the what? Is the area. No, M is the coefficient. X is the area. And B is the intercept. So let me get this coefficient, this M. To get it, I simply say reg dot qf. Very, very as simple as that. If I put this now and run. So that is the coefficient. And let me get the intercept, reg dot what? Intercept. It's as simple as that. Reg dot intercept on underscore, very, very important. If you don't put the underscore, it will read error. So that is the intercept. Okay, so with that, you can simply form your equation. And this is what it looks like. So with that, you can simply form your equation. And this is what your equation looks like. So I want everybody to try it out. Try it out. And let me see what you have. So if you put this out, this is what we're gonna get. So let's predict the price for area of 5,000 square meter. Reg dot predict, just the same way we predicted for 3,300. So I'm gonna make this prediction. If I click on run, you see, it has done the prediction. Okay. So finally, I can generate a CSV file from this, which I can use later for further work. I can also use a data areas.csv. You guys say you don't have areas.csv, but you have areas.csv. Okay, so I will show you how to create out. Okay, you can simply type it out like the way you did the homeprices.csv, but I'm going to give you the data for this. So this is the data for my area.dcsv. So I'm going to open it up. So this is my area.csv. So I'm just having some areas because I want to predict all their what? Prices. So this is just a collection of areas because I want to predict their prices. So simply prepare this in your Excel. Save it as what? Areas.csv. It has to be areas.csv. So do that. So I'm gonna read it out if I have it, since I already have it, but you know you don't have it. So create it before you can read it. Okay. So I'm going to make sure that my data, what I picked up is in order. Then before I do what? Run. Okay, so you can see my area has been red. You can see I have only three of them. So I want to predict the prices of these areas that I've just read. So how do I do that? I simply say what? Reg.predict. And I'm assigning it to variable what? P. So that I can see them immediately after predicting them. This ordinary P that I wrote here is just to show it after the prediction. So I get back here and put this and run. So you can see it has predicted their prices. This is three of them, 1,005 and 2,003. It's predicting their prices at what? 316,000, 384,000, and 492. So those are their prices. Okay. So I'm going to also make sure whenever you pick out a quote from our website, make sure the single quotes are the way they are supposed to be. So I'm going to arrange them now so that you can see everything. These are the areas and these are their prices. So the last thing I'm going to do is to put this in form of a CSV file so that I can use it another place in case if I want to use it tomorrow. So I'm going to read this to a CSV file and call that CSV file prediction.csv. Prediction.csv, that's what I want to do. So area underscore df dot, if you want to read something back into CSV, you simply say to underscore CSV. So put the name you want, make sure you're having the normal double quotes. Make sure you're having the normal double quotes. So I'm gonna click on run. So with that, I'm done. So I've finished predicting and I've read back my data, this very data into CSV. So now this data is in form of CSV. So if I want to start working on it again, I will have to read it out as CSV file. And how do you read out? You read out using what? pd.read underscore CSV. Then I'll put it here. But instead of giving this long directory, because I did not put it inside locally, I'll just put only what? Prediction.csv. Only prediction.csv will be here. All these other things, I shouldn't have them. So that is how to simply use linear regression to predict future prices. These are the prices I stopped at, but you can see now that I'm able to predict the prices for areas of 1,005,23. I was also able to predict area of 5,000 and area of 3,300. So from this data, my model is able to study this and make newer prediction. Remember, everything you want is in Christ Jesus. The surest way to getting success is by being born again. See you when I see you. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment section. If you are on YouTube, comment section of the YouTube. If you're on Facebook, comment section of the Facebook. Or you can simply call my number and ask me the question directly. The reason I put this out on my website is that after the lecture, you can simply go there, see all the codes and practice this by yourself. I can come again. We imported pandas because we want to use pandas to show our table, our data frame and organize it and manipulate it. We imported NumPy. Very, very importantly, NumPy is always used when you're doing such regression. Sklearn for our linear model in order to make our prediction. Then matplotlib in order for us to plot this graph that you have here. So after this importing, we read out our CSV file. Our CSV file is saved locally on our system. So we need to know the directory. Where did we save it? We saved it at in our C, inside the folder users. Inside our users folder, you have another folder user. Inside user, we have documents. Then we have data, desktop folder, data science. Then the name of the file is homeprices.csv. And we've already prepared this. And to prepare, you simply go to your what? MXSL, type it out, and save it as a CSV file. Very, very important. So once you've read it out, you're not seeing it. You want to see what you've read out. Simply just mention that variable, which is df. That's when you can see this. So having done this, the next thing will be to plot. In order to plot, I want to assign my y-axis to be price and my x-axis to be what? Area. That's why I did this plt.xlabel area and psc.ylabel price. That's how you are able to assign. If not, you'll be seeing X here, Y and X here. So for you to see price and area, that's why we did this. Is that clear? And we use PLT because PLT is from the what matplotlib model that we imported. So to bring out this very scatter, we use what plt.scatter because it's a function that is already there in our matplotlib. And we are plotting what against what? We are plotting price against what? Area. That's how you put it. Anything that should be on the y-axis, on the x-axis, that's what you write first. But the one that will be on the y-axis, you write it secondly. Are we clear on that? That is how you bring it in. Color is the color of your marker. Then marker is anything you want to use. If you want to use plus, so let me change it back to plus and change it back to what? Red color. I'm going to run. So you can see this is now plus, the marker is now plus and it's in red color. So the next thing we did was we are using our pandas using the pandas data frame to drop. We don't want to be seeing our prices again, this price column. We are having area and price, but we don't want price to be seen. We want only area. That's why we dropped. So that's why we dropped price column. That's why we're seeing only area. Now, if you want to see price again, this is how you bring out your price. Very simple. The next thing will be to create your model using linear regression. How do you do it? You simply assign linear model regression, which is a function in SQLN already. And you imported your SQLN as what? Linear underscore model. You're assigning it to the variable reg. So once you assign it to that variable, simply say reg.fit. That is how you create your model. Reg.fit. So once you say .fit, you've created your model. And your model is simply what? The predicted DF and your what? Price. And that will show this out once you do it. So with that, you can use it to make your predictions. So simply say that reg.predict. You put any area, you get your area, get the answer. If you want to know your equation, which is y equal to m of mx plus c. So your m, which is your coefficient, this is how you get it, reg.qf underscore. If you want to get your intercept, which is your c, simply say reg.intercept underscore. You're using reg because that is the name of the variable. It could be other things, I hope you know. In our last class, we use what? What do we do? Link reg, isn't it? So once you give the name of your variable, that's what you use. So we also predicted for size of 5,000. Then we now went inside our locally saved areas, locally saved CSV file containing many areas to predict all their prices. And these are those areas, and we used it to predict their prices. And these are their prices, and we can put it in tabular form, having the areas and the prices. Then after doing that, we read it back to a CSV. So we are now having a CSV file known as prediction.csv, having all the predicted values. So please check this out, study it very well. At first, it might not make much sense to you, but when you study it again, you're gonna find out that it's really, really simple. Okay, it's understandable. It's very clear. That's why I put it in the website so that you can look at it. It will be very understandable. If you don't understand it, you can read it up again. The procedure is very, very simple, very straightforward. Thank you. See you when I see you. God bless you.